ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وأرسله المولى تبارك وتعالى بالهدى ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله ولو كره الكافرون عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد إخوة الإسلام، أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، وهو الذي أوصانا في محكم التنزيل بقوله عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My dear respected brothers, as you know, we are still talking about the pillars of faith or the articles of faith, and we already in our previous khutbah we talk about the signs of the hour. Today our khutbah will be inshallah about the day of judgment. What will happen in that day? That scary day. That's the day that everybody is thinking about it, and everybody will be there. The day of judgment, my dear brothers, it's very important for to know about, for the Muslim. Just to know the importance of this day, that the Quran called that day with many different names. Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned the Quran about the day of judgment as Al-Haqqa, which is the inevitable day, and As-Sa'a, the hour, and As-Sakha, this is the titanium blast, At-Tammatul Kubra, overwhelming calamity, Al-Ghashiya, overwhelming event, Al-Qari'a, striking calamity, Al-Waqi'a, the occurrence, Al-Yawm Al-Akhir, the last day, Yawm Al-Ba'th, the day of resurrection, Yawm Al-Talaq, the day of meeting, Yawm Al-Jam', the day of assembly, Yawm Al-Hisab, the day of account, Yawm Al-Din, the day of judgment, and Yawm Al-Fasl, the sorting out day. And there are many names for that day. Why? Because it's very important. It was called the last day because there's no day after. When it will happen, no one knows except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَسْأَلُكَ النَّاسُ عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. People asking you about our, O Prophet. They're asking you about our. قُلْ إِنَّمَا عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ رَبِّي. Say, the knowledge of that time is with my Lord. Nobody knows this. Subhanallah. Even the Christian know, it was written in their book, that Jesus Christ, peace upon him, Isa alayhi salam, who they call as God or Son of God, may Allah Azza wa Jal forgive us from what they are saying, even though they say he doesn't know when is that time. And this is one evidence that Isa alayhi salam is a slave of God and he's not God or Son of God. So that day nobody knows. What day of the week? Yes, we know. How? Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told us that that day will start when? Yawm al-Jumu'ah, on Friday. So in the day of Friday, like today, all the creation are scared and alert, except the jinn and mankind. Everyone expecting the hour will stop. So this is the day, which, by name is Friday, but when, only Allah knows. My dear brothers, this is very important to know why. Because every once in a while, you read in the internet, and many people, they are predicting. They said, well, in two years, there will be the end of the world. In 5 years, 20 years, whatever you hear about the end of this world, nobody has knowledge about. Therefore, don't be deceived, ever. The Muslim should be wise. Don't be deceived by all this news. So, in Yawm al-Jum'ah, this is the day that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command at the start of the counting. This day will start by resurrection. Before resurrection, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send down a rain. And from this rain, the backbone of every human being who lived in this world, it doesn't ever destroy it. And from that piece of bones, the bodies will be grow up again, same like the plant. Till the full form body there, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bear between everybody and its soul. There are two nafkha, two time of blowing and the thumb, which is, will be done by al-Malak Israfil alayhi salam. At the first one, everything will die. Everything, every living thing will die, except what Allah He wants. And then, after that, when everything is dead, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will return the bodies, and then the second blowing, or blowing in the trump by Israfil, at this time, every soul will join its body. How long time between the two times? The Prophet ﷺ said 40. But we don't know what does it mean by 40. Is it 40 days? Is it 40 months? Is it 40 weeks? Is it 40 years? Only Allah knows. So at that time, people will come up for their accounting. And in that gathering, this or the earth where the people will be gathered, it will be flat. It's not like this earth. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضِ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ. When this earth will be changed to another earth and the heavens, subhanAllah. So this land where people will be gathered, it is flat. It is white. There is nothing, no mountain, no hills. Just flat. That will get and assemble the people from the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam till the last man who lived in this life or in this earth. How much space do you have? Only the space where you put your feet. It's very crowded. Just imagine how million and billion of people, and don't forget the jinn at that time when they are gathered at Yawm Al-Mahshar. Aisha radiallahu anha reported that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the people will be assembled barefoot, naked, and as circumcised. I said, look to the question of Aisha radiallahu anha. I said, O Messenger of Allah, will the men and women look at each other? You know, because with the modesty, the shyness, she was thinking about this. How come we get together, you know? They are mixed men and women. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, answer her. He said, the matter will be too serious for men to notice. Everybody at that day, he think about what? About his survival. That even he ran away from his parents, from his father, from his mother, from his brother, from his wife, from his children, everybody. Just he said, myself, 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 myself. That day will be, as mentioned in the Quran, equal to 50,000 years. One day. It will be equal to the length of 50,000 years. And the sun will come too close to the people. And everybody will be treated according to his deeds. This is why, my dear brother, don't ever try to apply the rules with understanding of this world to the day of judgment or to the hereafter or to anything of the unseen. The sun will come very close. They said meal, and the meal or mile, it has different meaning in Arabic. Either the mile that you know, the distance, or the meal which is very short, till the people will be sinking in their sweat, subhanAllah. And everybody will be treated according to his deed. So some of them, even with this hardship, this day will pass, it's like 1 hour for them. But for those, the disbelievers, it will, they will count every second of that day, and some people, they will sink in the desert. At that day, when people, they are waiting and waiting and waiting till they get tired, and then they come under distress. So when the distress becomes too great for the people on that day, what they will do? They have stood for too long, suffering in the heat and terror and disaster and distress. The Prophet ﷺ said, how will you, when Allah gather you together like a rose and a quiver for 50,000 years, during which Allah will not look at you? So the people will look to those who are of high status, like prophets, to intercede for them with their Lord, so that he might relieve them of this distress that they are suffering, and come to pass judgment among them. They just want to get out of this place and this situation. No, that matter. They don't think about either to paradise or to hell. Just get us out of, from here. So they go to Adam alayhi salam, and they said, oh Adam, you are the father of mankind. Will you intercede? Ask Allah to start the judgment. And then Adam will excuse himself. He said, go to Ibrahim. And then they go to Ibrahim. And Ibrahim will tell them to Musa. And Musa will tell them to Isa alayhi salam. And then Isa, he will say, no one can intercede except Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So they go to Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam, and he said, Ana laha. Allah Azza wa Jal promised him that he will be the one. And this is the maqam Mahmud. Mahmud, that means everybody praise him for this, you know, standing. Maqam al Mahmud, that we always ask Allah Azza wa Jal after the salah to give it to our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he said, Ana laha. I'll be the one. So he go prostrate in front of the throne of Allah and stay there and prostrating, praising Allah from words that Allah Azza wa Jal will reveal to him, so that he never was praised in, like this word. And then Allah Azza wa Jal subhanahu wa ta'ala will say to him, raise your head, ask will be given. So the Prophet ﷺ said, what? Ummati, Ummati, my nation, my people, my followers. And then he asked Allah Azza wa Jalla to start the judgment, to start the judgment. And then will come the angels with the records. So the records, everybody will get his book of deeds. Some of them, they will get it in their right side, right hand. Others, the disbelievers and those sinners, they will get it in their left, and they get it from their back as a humiliation for them. So the one who will give it in his right hand, he will shout, enjoy. And he said, come and read my book. I was believing that this day will come. So he's very joyful because he sees the success. And the one who get it in his left hand, he will say, I wish that I didn't get my book. And I wish that I was in and dead forever. So that day, my dear brothers, that everybody should be prepared for. At that day, everything will be put in scale. Your deed will be put in scale. Even you yourself, you will put in the scale. Where we get this? We get this from the hadith with the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When some of the Sahaba, they make fun of the leg of Mas'ud, he said that his leg is more in weight in the scale of their judgment than the mountain of Uhud. So people will be weighted and their deeds will be weighted, everything will be weighted and put in that scale. The believer will not be accounted in the way that is for the disbeliever. It is only out. فَأَمَّا مَنْ أَعْطَى كِتَابَهُ فَسَوْفَ يُحَاسَبُ حِسَابًا يَسِيرًا. It is very easy accounting. So, when the people ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, because there's another hadith that said, whoever was put in accountants, he will be loser. So, how come the believer will be in this situation? They said, he said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, this is only to inform about what he's did. So Allah Azza wa Jal will get the believer near to him, and he said, do you remember the sin of that day. Do you remember this? Do you remember that? And he said, yes, my Lord. And then Allah Azza wa Jal said, I cover it for you in dunya and I forgive you for it today. So this is a blessing of Allah Azza wa Jal for those who believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Barakallahu li wa lakum bil Qur'an al-Azim wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayi wa al-dhikr al-hakim. Alhamdulillah, as-salatu was-salamu ala rasulillah. After the counting, then people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hide the light, so it will be very darkness. And the hell will get to be very near. And then the bridge will be over the hellfire that will take people to the other side, which is Jannah. Everybody will pass over that bridge. This is what's called a Sirat. This bridge is more thin than the hair, more sharp than the sword. And people passing this bridge or through it, they are different in speed. It's not a matter of skill that you train yourself in this world to be very high speed runner. No, it depends on your deed, how close you to Allah. Some of them, they will pass it like lightning, very quick. Some like a horse, some like very fast runner, some walking, and some they will fall down from there to the head. May Allah Azza wa Jal save us all from that end. And then after they pass this bridge, the people of paradise will be gathered, and then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he will be the first one who will enter Jannah, and his ummah will be the first nation that will enter Jannah. And for the people of the hell, there will be, you know, in that destination for what they did in this world, if it is believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is a group who are deceiving Muslims and deceiving people in this world. Those are hypocrites who they are living with a Muslim and they show they are a believer and they are mocking against Islam and Muslim. But they were treated in this world as Muslim because they show they are a Muslim. Like the hypocrites at the time of the Prophet. And they are always, in every time they exist. So the Day of Judgment, subhanAllah, Allah Azza wa Jal will treat them the same way. They deceive the believer here, and at that day, they will walk with the believers. They think that they are saved. But then, when the dark starts, everybody will walk according to his light, the light that was given for him because of his good deed. These hypocrites, they don't have good deeds. So they will have dark. So they will shout on the believer. They said, wait for us, we'll walk with you so we can see our way with your light. It will be said to them, go back and get light for yourself. And they cannot come to this world to be blind. Because this light only will come through the good deeds. So my dear brothers, we should learn more about this day. Read a lot about it, but be careful. Take your information, your Islamic knowledge from very authentic sources. Don't be deceived for whatever published in the internet or newspaper or any paper or any source. You should retain whenever you are thinking or you want to learn about anything which is related to the Aqeedah, then you should go back to authentic sources. إِنَّ اللَّهُ مَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وعن الخلفاء الراشدين الأربعة المهديين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين وعن معهم رحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين واحمي حوزة الدين. اللهم اجعل هذا البلد رخاء سخاء آمنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا ودودنا وأصلح أمتنا ولاة أمورنا وأيد بتوفيقك إمامنا وولي أمرنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا مجيب الدعوات. اللهم إنا نسألك رضاك والجنة وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل، ونعوذ بك من سخطك ومن النار وما قرب إليها من قول وعمل. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واذكروا الله العظيم الجليل يذكركم واشكروا على نعمه يزدكم، ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.